Hey guys, welcome back for another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez. You can find me on Twitter at JR from PTC. In this tutorial, we'll take a look at two different techniques to remove hair from its background. The first technique will work with almost every version of Photoshop, while the second will only work if you have Photoshop CS5 or newer. For this tutorial, I wanted a challenge. I was looking for an image of a person who had some wild frizzy hair. I definitely didn't want to make this easy for you guys. The hair in this image does not seem like it will be easy to mask, but as you will see in this tutorial, this is not the case. If you follow along, you'll soon be masking hair like nobody's business. And before you get started, you might want to pause the video and head over to my website, PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com, if you're not already there, and download the tutorial file so you can follow along. Okay guys, so I'll be showing you two different techniques of masking out hair. The first technique is going to be applicable to pretty much all versions of Photoshop. The second will require Photoshop CS5 or newer. So let me show you the first technique. We have the image of this woman here, and we have a background. So this is the background we're trying to place her in. And as you can see, this is not an easy job. There's a lot of strands of hair going all over the place. So it's gonna take a little bit of work, but don't worry. It's not that hard to get this woman into the background. So before we get started, we're gonna duplicate the woman layer, and that's because we're gonna use one layer per technique. So I'm just gonna click on the woman layer and press Control J, that's Command J on the Mac, to duplicate that layer. And then we're gonna talk a little bit about channels in case you're not familiar with them, since we will be using them for the first part of the tutorial. So each RGB image is created with three channels, the red channel, green channel, and blue channel. And without going into too much detail, these three channels help create the final RGB image. And these channels can also be used as selections. So if I press Control or Command on my keyboard and click on any of these channel icons, you'll load a selection. And just like with layer mask, white are the opaque pixels and black are the invisible pixels. So I made a selection around this blue channel. I'm going to go back into the layers panel. And by the way, this is not really part of the masking out process. I just want to explain to you how channels work. So I'm going to create a new layer and I'm just going to fill it with black. And I'm going to shut off the visibility to the other layers just so you can see how that works. I'm going to press Control D, Command D to deselect the selection. And you'll see that there's black pixels and no pixels here. That's because I gotta bring back this woman so we can see the channels. That's because in the blue channel, this section was white, which means the pixels are gonna show, or actually gray, which is why it's faded black. And this area here is black, which means it's gonna hide the pixels. So that's why we get that result there. And to see it more clearly, I'm gonna press Control J couple times just so you can see how it's in fact black here and invisible here. So now that we know that, we're gonna use the channels to select the hair. So in your image, select the channel that's got more contrast between the hair and the background. In this case is the blue channel, so I'm gonna duplicate that channel by clicking and dragging it over into the new channel icon, this icon here. So now I can work on this icon. You never want to work on the original red, green, or blue channels. You always want to duplicate them. Now that I have it duplicated, I know that I don't want to select this white area. I want to select the black pixels. So I got to turn the black pixels white and the white pixels black. To do that, I'm simply going to press Control I. That's Command I on the Mac. So now we can see that we can select around these white pixels here. But these pixels are too light, so we have to darken those up. And we also obviously want to keep the face, so we got to make this white. The easiest way to do that is by grabbing the lasso tool. You can just press L on the keyboard if you like. And just go around this area here. And we can fill that with white. I'm going to press Control D, Command D to deselect. I'm going to press B on the keyboard for my brush tool. And I'm going to paint with white around the shoulder here and the other shoulder. And I'm not going to take too much time since we're mostly worried about the hair, of course. Okay, So now that I've painted everything inside here white, I have to turn everything in the outside black. The easiest way to do that is by going into Edit, Image, Adjustment, Levels, and I can bring in the levels to the right, like so, making these pixels darker. Now, you see the strands of hair here. You want to make sure that you don't go too far and get rid of them. So you got to find that balance. So maybe somewhere around here. So you can still kind of see them. You still have the ones on the top. You still have the ones on this side. So just press OK when you're done. And now we're going to use the Burn tool. And we're going to set the range to shadows and the exposure. We're going to keep that very low at 6%. Will be okay. And as you can see, it'll make the dark grays black. But if you paint on white, nothing would happen. So when we start painting around this area, you'll see that it'll leave the strands of hair intact, but it'll make the background black. So I'm just going to do something like this. Here as well, and on this side. And I'm probably going a little faster than I normally would just because I want to make this tutorial short. So now that we've done that, we can probably go into the image adjustment levels menu one more time and just make it a little bit darker here. Maybe it was a little too much. Maybe we'll make the midtones just a little bit darker, something like that, and then press OK. Now we can press Control Command on the channel icon here to make a selection out of the blue channel copy. Go back into the layers panel. I can add a layer mask here. Now I'm going to shut off the visibility to this layer. And if I bring up the bathroom background layer, you see the good job this did. I'm going to zoom in just so you can see. See, it did a pretty good job at selecting the hair. Now there's a few problems that I'm going to show you how to fix in a moment. There's areas where I wish there was more hair, there was more density. So what I'm going to do is select the woman copy, and we'll just call this hair, just so we know what we're working with. Hair. We'll call that layer hair. And I'm going to press Control J. And notice that when I did that, it added more density to some of the areas, like here and here. And this is looking pretty good. So another thing I can do is create a new layer. Select the eyedropper tool and pick one of the darker browns here, so maybe something like that. Then press Control Command on the layer mask here to make a selection out of that mask, and I can fill that mask with my foreground color by holding Alt and Backspace, that's Option and Backspace on the Mac. I'm going to press Control D, Command D to deselect, and I'm going to use this layer to fill in some of the strands of hair that you see here on the bottom. So I'm going to create a layer mask by clicking on this icon here. But before I do so, I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard, and that's going to create an inverted mask. It's going to hide everything. Now, keep in mind that the pixels are only where the selection is, so we don't have to worry about staying within the lines. So I'm going to enable the layer again. And if I paint with the brush tool with white, you'll see how the strands of hair start showing up. And let me zoom in just so you can get a better view of that. See the strands of hair that are just slowly appearing? And I got a little bit of the shoulder there, so just be careful when you're doing it. I'm not going to take time to delete it, because if you go too far into the image, you'll start coloring. You'll start painting that color inside the image, and you don't want to do that, so just be careful. Anyway, so I'm just going to go around the image, and I'm just going to bring some of those strands of hair back that got lost, like so. Right over here, like so. And we're going to get a few more up here. So look at that. That looks beautiful. And you know what, if you want to be more realistic in your image, I'm just using one solid color just to show you how it works. But you can obviously pick different colors that match the hair color better. So notice how up here when I painted over it really doesn't match. So I could do several things. I could either choose another color and then paint with it, or I could even use the clone stamp tool and try to clone some of those in there, but I'm not going to take the time to do that. Feel free to do so in your image if you want to. Oh, and by the way, just now I noticed I made a small mistake when I was painting. When I chose a different color, I was actually in the layer masks, not in the layer. So when I painted, it painted the same color, obviously, because I didn't move over into this layer. But anyway, I'm sure you get what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna continue doing this, and I'm gonna go a little bit faster so I can show you the other technique if you have Photoshop CS6, actually CS5, CS6, or CC. And there we go. And I got a little bit over the shoulder, so actually I'll just undo that and paint again. So as you can see, this is the final image, and notice how it almost looks like she's really there. Look at that hair. I think it looks great. And it didn't take us that long to do. This tutorial so far has been about 9 minutes or so, but I've been talking and showing you channels and stuff like that. If I wasn't explaining how things were done, I could probably do this in just a couple minutes, and I'm sure you can as well, as long as you remember the steps. So I'm gonna put all of these into one folder, and I'm just gonna call this folder channel to remind us that we created this extraction using the channels panel. So I'm gonna do the same thing again, but this time I'm gonna use a tool that I believe started in CS5. I could be wrong. If I am, just feel free to leave a message and tell me in what version it started. But I'm gonna create a quick selection with the quick selection tool. And oops, sorry about that. I'm in the wrong folder or layer here. I should be in the woman layer. And I'm just gonna press Control Z to undo all that and make sure I'm in the woman layer. And I'm gonna make a selection around her using the quick selection tool, but I need to make sure that after I'm done with the selection, I go and remove some parts. These parts here, where there's no, and I'll zoom in just so you can see, where there's no large clumps of hair, just a few strands, we gotta remove that. So I'm gonna hold Alt, and notice on the brush, when I hold Alt, you get a little minus sign. Well, hold Alt, when you see the minus sign, just deselect those areas like there and maybe here and here. Essentially any area that's got that gray because there's not enough hair to cover the entire background. So maybe these areas here, here. And actually I have to add the shoulder. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom out. And by the way, when I zoom out, I'm holding Alt and using the mouse wheel to zoom out or zoom in, and that's option on the Mac. Okay, so now that I've got this selection, I can click on the layer mask icon and create a layer mask around that. And obviously, this is not looking as good as the other extraction yet. But what we're gonna do now is click on Mask Edge right here in the properties for the layer mask, Mask Edge. And this is the tool here, the Refine Radius tool. I think that was added in CS5. And as I said before, if I'm mistaken, just leave a message down below and let everybody know what version it started in. Anyway, so with this tool selected, I can change the size of this brush. So for this particular case, something around 92 should work okay. And I'm just gonna start painting around the selection where the hair is. Like so, maybe here. And notice that I'm going really fast. You don't have to be exact at all with this tool. You can just paint fairly quickly, like so. Here. Okay? And then just let go. And look at the wonderful job this tool did. It just pretty much got rid of everything that was gray. I'm gonna press OK. I'm gonna zoom in, and you can see it did a terrific job. And we can do what we did before with the other tool. I'm gonna zoom out. And I can press Control J to duplicate that layer to add more density, like so. And I, of course, can create a selection around the hair by clicking Command or Control on the layer mask icon. After I make the selection, I can create a new layer, fill it with that same brown we were using before. I don't need to select the new color since we're using the same image. I'm going to press Control D to deselect. I'm going to create a new layer mask on that layer two, but I'm going to hold Alt to invert the selection as we did before. Press B on the keyboard to bring back my brush tool. And with white, I can continue painting on those strands of hair to make them more more noticeable as we did before. So as you can see, we're bringing some of those strands of hair back. And I'm sure you're looking at this right now and thinking, wow, I never thought I would be able to extract an image that looked like this, but I purposely took an image that had some really, really gnarly hair so you could really see the possibilities of extracting hair with Photoshop and how easy it is to do. For some reason, a lot of people think it's hard, but it's really not if you know the steps. And again, I'm going faster than I normally would, and I would probably select different colors and try to match the highlights and all of that, but I don't think it's necessary. I just wanted to show you how to make that selection. So I'm gonna grab those and turn them into a group, and this will be Refine Edge, because that's the tool that we use to create the selection. And you can move her around and you see that, you know, she pretty much looks good everywhere she goes. Now, when you're working with your image, remember that the background has a lot to do with how your image looks. So a lot of times, some backgrounds would just not work just because of the lighting and the texture on the background. So don't feel too discouraged if your image does not look as good as you were intending it to. I'm actually going to finish up the tutorial with one thing that I was not planning to do. I'm going to click on the top layer here. I'm going to add a photo filter just so the entire composition has the same tone. It makes these two images look as if they belong together. So that's one little trick there for you. After you finish up your composition, just add a filter. You can do a warming one, a cooling one. In this particular case, I just think the regular warming filter works. So as you can see, it just sort of makes everything look like it belongs. And you can bring the opacity down if you want. But in this particular case, I think 100% works fine. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you have any comments, leave them down below. Also, remember to go to my website and enter your email on the sidebar so you can become a Photoshop Training Channel newsletter subscriber and receive email notifications every time I put up a new tutorial, and also receive subscriber-only tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys again next time.